Nouns. Nouns from destitute hesed, which means grace in Hebrew. They come from Brazil after being there with the Holy Father. There are four of them, Kelly and Patricia, Shoni Madeline, Maria Cecilia, and one new community. There are 130 brothers and sisters. And they were here as the fruits of Our Lady's apparitions here in Medjugorje. In the beginning, we will hear a song, and then we will hear their witness, their testimony.
Jesus, Maria e José. Louvado seja nosso Senhor Jesus Cristo e sua mãe Maria Santíssima.
Praise be Jesus and Mary.
Gostaria de começar cantando canto a Nossa Senhora.
Počeću jednom pjesmom za. I will begin with a song for a lady. It is called the one that receives.
Bom dia.
Dobar dan.
Eu me chamo Kelly Patricia, do Instituto Hesed.
My name is Sister Kelly Patricia from the Institute Hesed. Hesed is a Hebrew word for grace. I come from Brazil, from one very Christian family. My mother prayed every evening rosary for her four children.
Patricia is Instituta Hesed. Hesed je hebrejska riječ za milosrđe. Dolazim iz Brazila, iz jedne vrlo kršćanske obitelji. Moja je majka svake večeri molila krunicu sa nas četvoro djece.
Nossa família era muito modesta, pois meu pai.
Our family lived in a very modest way, because my father abandoned my mother, and she had a very hard time to live and to provide for her four children. Regardless of that, she gave us a Christian upbringing, and she poured love and devotion towards the Blessed Virgin Mary.
I ona je teškom mukom uzdržavala svoje četvero djece. Svejedno nam je dala kršćanski odgoj i usadila nam je ljubav i pobožnost prema blaženoj djevici Mariji.
Eu conheci Medjugorje quando o padre da minha paróquia passou vídeo sobre as aparições de Nossa Senhora em Medjugorje. Isto aconteceu por volta dos anos 80.
I met Medjugorje when one priest from my parish showed the video about the apparitions of Our Lady in Medjugorje. That was back in the 80s. Our mom took us to watch that movie, and I was really impressed by that, even though I was really little.
Majka nas je povela pogledati taj film koji me se duboko dojmio, iako sam bila još mala.
Depois ela comprou livro que falava sobre Medjugorje, sobre as aparições. E eu o li na minha adolescência. Eu não conseguia parar de ler, pois senti.
Later on, I bought a book about the apparitions in Medjugorje. I read that book when I was growing up. I was a teenager. I could not stop reading. I wanted to read the whole book as soon as possible. I read the book back home, in the school, during the vacations. I spoke about the book to my colleagues. The events in Medjugorje really, really impressed me.
Čitala sam je kao adolescentica. Nisam se mogla otrgnuti od čitanja. Htjela sam što brže pročitati cijelu knjigu. Čitala sam kod kuće, u školi, za vrijeme odmora. O toj sam knjizi govorila svojim kolegama. Međugorski događaji na mene su ostavili jako dubok dojam.
Desde criança tive gosto pela oração. Foi aos 15 anos que decidi ser religiosa. E ao descobrir a espiritualidade do Carmelo e as obras dos santos carmelitas, como São João da Cruz, Santa Teresa, Santa Teresinha, decidi doar minha vida a Deus e à Igreja, vivendo num mosteiro carmelita descalço na cidade onde nasci, Fortaleza, no Brasil.
As a little girl, I really loved praying. When I was 15, I decided to become a priest, a nun. After I discovered the spirituality of Carmel and part of Holy Carmelites and the works of Holy Carmelites, St. John of the Cross and the great St. Teresa of Avila and Little Teresa of Child Jesus, I decided to give my life to God and the church in the monastery of Birvid in my birth town, Fortaleza, in Brazil. I entered Carmel when I was 19, and I remained there for 2.5 years. In one very difficult moment for my family, because my mom was ill, the Mother Superior allowed me to go out and to help my mother, because she really needed help.
I ostala 2.5 godine. U jednom vrlo teškom trenutku za moju obitelj, kada je moja majka se teško razbolila, zađem i pomognem majci.
I was helping my mom thanks to Christian music. I always loved singing, and I sang in the parish, I sang at the Holy Mass, I sang in the prayer group of young people. I started recording and selling CDs, and I started performing all over Brazil.
Pomogla sam joj zahvaljujući kršćanskoj glazbi. Uvijek sam voljela pjevati, pjevala sam u župnoj katehezi, na misi i u molitvenoj skupini mladih. Počela sam snimati CD-ove i nastupati širom Brazila.
Neste período, eu
At that time, in the Marian community, Oasis of Peace, I met spirituality of Medjugorje, and I really, really wished one day to come to Medjugorje.
U to sam vrijeme u Marijanskoj zajednici Oaza Mira susrela duhovnost Međugorja i žarko poželjela jednoga dana doći u Međugorje.
Fiz uma experiência de discernimento, pois eu estava em busca de discernir se eu deveria retornar ao Carmelo ou permanecer fora.
At that time, there was a question of discerning. I needed to discern, should I go back to Carmel or remain outside, since I felt vocation to become a missionary that sang at God's glory, and people were saying to me at that time, I should stop singing.
U Carmel ili ostati vani. Budući da sam osjećala poziv da budem misionarka, a i ljudi su
Então eu pensei.
I thought about that, and that I decided together with my spiritual leader. That time it was Father Adelia Tomasin. I decided to continue the music mission that I had.
I odlučila sam da ću nastaviti to glazbeno poslanje.
Neste período, uma amiga de minha mãe me procurou e disse assim, de repente, Nossa Senhora quer que você vá a Medjugorje. Eu disse.
Then a friend of my mom came and she said, Our Lady wants you to go to Medjugorje. I told her, I want that as well, but that's not possible. And she said to me, I will pay all for you. You just need to go.
Ali to je nemoguće. A ona meni, ja ću ti sve platiti, samo ti idi.
Eu fiquei muito impressionada.
I was really, really impressed by that. I was even afraid to accept such a great gift. My mom and I prayed for that intention, and finally she told me, My daughter, go. Our Lady wants you to go.
Pois é, Nossa Senhora, quem quer?
To me se duboko dojmilo. Bojala sam se čak prihvatiti tako veliki dar. Mama i ja smo molili, na kraju mi ona rekla, idi kćeri, Gospa tako hoće.
It was the pilgrimage that led us through various Marian shrines throughout Europe, and finally we came to Medjugorje. As we flew from Brazil to Europe, next to me there was a young woman who was sitting next to me, and I became friends with her straight away.
To je hodočašće vodilo kroz razna marijanska svetišta širom Europe, a na kraju je bilo i Međugorje. Na letu iz Brazila u Europu, pored mene je sjedila jedna mlada djevojka s kojom sam se odmah mogla identificirati.
Não a conhecia antes, mas me pareceu que já nos conhecíamos há muito tempo. Seu nome era Jane Madeleine. E estava vivendo uma belíssima experiência de conversão.
I did not know her, and it seemed to me that we knew each other for a long time. Her name was Jane Madeleine, and she was going through a beautiful experience of conversion with Jesus and Mary, and she was in the same group of pilgrims as I was.
I proživljavala jedno predivno iskustvo obraćenja uz Isusa u Mariju i Mariju i bila je u istoj skupini hodočasnika kao i ja.
Nós tivemos momentos muito especiais nos santuários que passávamos, mas aqui em Medjugorje foi uma coisa muito linda, tanto para mim quanto para ela.
Doživjeli smo lijepe trenutke u svim
We lived beautiful moments in all of the shrines that we visited, but here in Medjugorje there was something special for her and for me as well.
Foi aqui em Medjugorje que Jane Hoje, nossa madre...
Here in Medjugorje, Jane, today she is our Mother Superior. She had strong experience with Our Lady. She came here to see Our Lady and Blessed Virgin Mary told her that she wants her to found an institute of religious life based on the spirituality of God's mercy, of divine mercy.
Naša danas generalna poglavarica imala snažno iskustvo s Gospom. Ona je došla ovamo Gospi i blažena djevica Marija joj je rekla da želi da se osnuje institut redovničkog života koji se temelji na duhovnosti božanskoga milosrđa.
Madre Jeanne, porém, não entendia muito.
Mother Jeanne did not know much about religious life, nor how to found religious congregations. She was a lay person.
A još manje kako osnovati nekakvu redovničku kongregaciju. Ona je bila laik.
No final da peregrinação, eu permaneci na Itália por tempo, para discernir se voltava para o Brasil ou não. Tentando descobrir a vontade de Deus para minha vida. Pois antes da peregrinação, eu escrevi projeto de vida.
At the end of the pilgrimage, I remained in Italy because I wanted to discern, should I go back to Brazil or not? And in search for God's will before going to the pilgrimage, I put on paper my life project. It was some kind of rule for my personal life. I did not know where I belonged.
U potrazi za voljom Božjom, prije odlaska na hodočašće, zapisala sam na papir svoj životni projekt, nešto kao neko pravilo za moj osobni život, jer nisam znala na koje mjesto pripadam.
Neste período de discernimento, este período de discernimento se passou num santuário de Nossa Senhora do Carmo, na Sardenha. Lá me senti muito bem, pois a espiritualidade carmelitana sempre me acompanhou.
Before that time of discerning, I spent in the shrine of Our Lady of Carmel at Sardinia in Italy. I felt really good well because Carmelite spirituality always followed me. With help of one of the priests, I decided to return to Brazil.
Jednog svećenika odlučila sam se vratiti.
Porém, antes mesmo que eu soubesse que voltaria para o Brasil, quando ainda estava em Portugal, Nossa Senhora disse à Madre Jeanne,
before my decision on returning, on the day of return to Brazil, while we were still in Portugal, Our Lady said to Mother Jeanne, which day and which month shall I go back to Brazil? When I called her to say that I decided to come back, she told me that she already knows that I will go back.
Gospa je rekla majci Jean, kojega dana i kojega mjeseca ću se ja vratiti u Brazil. Tako da, kad sam je nazvala da joj kažem da se vraćam, ona mi je rekla da već zna. Zna da ću se vratiti i kada ću se vratiti.
Quando eu cheguei no Brasil, ela me falou, Nossa Senhora me disse que você tem uma regra de vida. Eu respondi, uma regra? Mas como Nossa Senhora contava tudo por antecipação para ela, ficava difícil não se impressionar. E foi esta regra que serviu de base inicial.
So when I arrived, she told me, Our Lady told me that you wrote a life rule, and I said to her, rule? Our Lady knew all of that. It was hard not to be surprised at that. It was the rule that served as a ground point for our first constitutions.
Teško je tome se ne čuditi. To je pravilo poslužilo kao polazišna točka za naše prve konstitucije.
A partir de então, começamos a rezar juntas, jejuar, fazer momentos de adoração ao Santíssimo e caminhadas penitenciais, a fim de permanecer unidas a Deus e podermos seguir e fazer somente Sua Santíssima vontade. Até que em 30 de novembro de 1990.
From that moment, we started praying together, we started fasting, adoring the Blessed Sacrament, doing penance, just to remain united with God, that God may lead us to do only His will. On November 13th, 1997, we began the Institute Hesed in the town Fortaleza in Brazil. As I said, Hesed is the Hebrew word for grace, for divine mercy.
Činimo samo njegovu volju. 30. studenog 97. započeli smo institut Hesed u gradu Fortaleza u Brazilu. Kako već rekoh, Hesed je hebrejska riječ za milosrđe.
Assim temos a espiritualidade carmelitana, a devoção à divina misericórdia e uma união muito grande com a Rainha da Paz. Com a espiritualidade.
We have a Carmelite spirituality, devotion towards divine mercy, and we are deeply united with the Queen of Peace, with Medjugorje spirituality. That was the beginning of the Institute Hesed, and all began here in Medjugorje.
Smo sjedinjeni s kraljicom mira, s međugorskom duhovnošću. To je bio početak instituta Hesed, a sve je počelo ovdje, u Međugorju.
Para mim é uma graça muito grande poder estar contando isto para vocês. Graça ainda maior de estar aqui hoje, que é o aniversário de Nossa Senhora, como ela disse aqui em Međugorje.
Za mene je velika milost što mogu svjedočiti ovdje pred vama.
It is a great grace that I'm able to witness before you. It is a bigger grace to be here on a lady's birthday. As she said that here in Medjugorje. In the Institute has said we live and we spread the messages of the Queen of Peace and Medjugorje spirituality. In the monasteries we have constant adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. We fast, we read the Holy Scripture, Lectio Divina. We very often confess, we go to Holy Mass. Every Saturday we organize prayer, just like in Medjugorje. We sing the similar songs and we read Our Lady's messages. Every week there are about 300 people coming.
U samostanima imamo neprekidno klanjanje. Postimo, čitamo Sveto pismo, Lectio Divina. Često se ispovjedamo, idemo na misu.
E todos os sábados realizamos momento de adoração inspirado no de Medjugorje, com canções semelhantes e com a leitura de mensagem da Rainha da Paz, da qual participam semanalmente por volta de 300 pessoas.
Svake subote organiziramo molitvu kao u Međugorju. Pjevamo slične pjesme i čitamo gospinu poruku. I svakoga tjedna dolazi oko 300 ljudi.
I'm here to testify to you what kind of a joy is to live only for God, along with 130 spiritual sons and daughters in the Institute Hesed in 5 different monasteries in Brazil. I'm asking you to pray. Please pray for us that we may remain faithful to what the Lord asks from us and to what Our Lady reminds us to do.
Aconselha.
Ja sam ovdje da posvjedočim kakva je radost živjeti samo za Boga i zajedno sa 130 duhovnih kćeri i sinova u Institutu Hesed u 5 samostana u Brazilu. Molim vas da molite za nas, da budemo vjerni onome što Gospodin od nas traži i onome na što nas Gospa podsjeća.
E como nosso carisma é cantar as misericórdias do Senhor, gostaria de terminar com canto inspirado em Santa Teresinha, que pede que Jesus transforme nossa pequenez em amor.
Budući da je naša karizma...
Since our charism is a distinct divine mercy, I will complete with a song that was inspired with the Saint Therese of Child Jesus. In that song, she asks Jesus to transform our littleness and weaknesses into love.
Io vorrei soltanto ti dire, dimmi fai capire cose la vita, che allegria e dolore vanno insieme in me, ma ciò che conta è l'amore. Viene, prendi possesso di me, vinci la mia impotenza, il mio niente, Signore. Ah, tutto ti voglio dare, anche quanto non ho, anche ciò che non sono, poiché ciò che conta è l'amore. Amore, fai del mio niente amore, solo amore. Amore, Gesù, fai del mio niente amore, so che vivere è amare, che amare è soffrire, che amare è consegnarsi. Ah, ben piccola sono, come desiderare soltanto vivere d'amore. Ma tutto poi in me, un tuo unico sguardo, tutto in me cambierà. Non essendo più di che sono, essendo tutto amore, vivrò per sempre al tuo fianco, Signore. Essendo tutto amore, fai del mio niente amore, solo amore. Amore, Gesù, fai del mio niente amore. Eu queria só te dizer, que me fizesse entender o que é a vida, que alegria e dor andam juntas em mim, mas o que conta é o amor. Vem, toma posse de mim, vem ser minha impotência, o meu nada, Senhor. Ah, tudo quero te dar, mesmo o que não tenho, mesmo o que não sou, pois o que conta é o amor. O amor faz do meu nada amor, só amor. Amor, Jesus, faz do meu nada amor. Sei que viver é amar, que amar é sofrer, que amar é se dar. Ah, bem pequena eu sou, como então desejar só viver de amor? Mas tudo podes em mim, o teu único olhar, tudo em mim mudará. E não sendo mais do que sou, sendo todo amor, viverei para sempre ao teu lado, Senhor. Sendo todo amor, faz do meu nada amor, só amor. Amor, Jesus, faz do meu nada amor. Grazie mille.
We thank Sister Kelly Patricia and her sisters for having come here all the way from Brazil to be here in these days of the festival, of the youth festival. They have also brought a couple of hundreds of CDs that they would like to share with you, and you can get those stands for free. Thank you so much for that.